So hello and welcome everyone. I'm Pushpendra and I'll be your host for Not So Lame Quiz, presented by Quiz Club IIT Patna under the quiz series Parak. So let us go through the rules once. So the quiz is open for all. There are 20 questions in the quiz and there are no negatives. Question number 1 to 15 each carry 1 point, and in case of multiple parts to a question, points will be divided equally. Questions 16 to 20 are star marked and each carries 2 points, and they will be used to resolve ties. You have to type in your answers in the G form provided to you. So the link to the G form is in the group, is in the video description. Also, if you are viewing this on the website, then the G form should be embedded there. You have to submit the G form within 90 seconds after the last question is closed, which is the 20th question. And also remember that there will be no rerun of the questions. So as we reach the last question, we won't be going back. And as always, any unfair means would lead to disqualification. So let us begin. Lights, camera, action. The first question. So a creative company redesigned some of their iconic music covers to spread awareness about what? So a fairly simple question to begin the quiz. You just have to identify for raising awareness about what these iconic music covers are edited. So preferably a two-word answer. We'll be moving on to the second question in 5 seconds. Question number 2. So, though it is not clear if the production studio ran out of costumes or it was a clever way to cut short the budget during the shooting of X. X is a recent addition to a popular series. The crew of X reached out to arguably the most dedicated fan organization of this series, and it was a dream come true for them, as the crew of X asked them to join the shooting in their highly accurate and detailed white armor costumes, which are exact clones of each other. So the key terms to look out for are white armor costumes and clones of each other, and a recent addition to a popular series. So you have to identify which popular series, like the recent addition to a popular series, I am talking about. Five more seconds and we'll move on to the third question. Question number 3. So this is what the author says about how she got the idea to write this book. One night, I'm sitting there flipping around, and on one channel, there's a group of young people competing for, I don't know, maybe money. And on the next, there's a group of young people fighting an actual war. And I was tired and the lines begin to blur in this very unsettling way, and I thought of this story. When asked if it was always planned as a series or the idea came after the first book, the author replied that while at the end of the first book, she realized that the actions of the protagonist would have repercussions, and thus the story wasn't complete. So which book series is the author talking about? So 5 more seconds, then we'll move on to the next question. question number four. So there is a museum in Austria which is quite unique. As the founder of the museum remarks, we allow a different look at art. This museum celebrates this art of dash, which although is condemned but requires a lot of skills. These artists featured here have had their own different ways to learn their art, which may involve schooling, self-teaching, or simply a desire to learn to paint. And virtually all of them had to live anonymously. In addition to the paintings here, the museum also tries to raise awareness about this issue and tells about the dramatic lives of these artists. So you have to tell me what is so special about this museum. So stress on the fact that these artists have to live anonymously. Five more seconds, then we'll move on to the next question. Question number five. So one of the stories about how the band got its name is as follows. When the band was being formed, someone quoted the English idiom that it would go down like a balloon made of X, implying that it would fail. Just like how a balloon made of X, one of the heaviest metals, can never rise. The group worked around this idiom, replacing the word balloon with something which essentially was a big, large balloon used by Germans in World War I. So, which band are we talking about? So, X, which is X is one of the heaviest metals which can never rise, and the another inspiration is a large balloon used by Germans during World War I. So you have to name which band we are talking about. Okay, moving on to the next question in 5 seconds. Question number six. So there's this game that follows the life of X, who is an ex-police officer, as he tries to unravel the conspiracy of his family's death. The story writer of the game is shown in the image, and it is the face of the story writers that is used for the face of, like, that is used for modeling the face of X in the game. So X is both the name of the game and the name of the protagonist. So ideally, I'm looking for a two-word answer, which is the name of the protagonist, and whose face is modeled after the story writer whose image is shown. Moving on to the next question in 5 seconds. Question number 7. His companion, a less imaginative type, sat with his legs spread wide over the long coffin-shaped box which contained in its compartments the three dash that would continue to indefinitely and which no one so far had ever seen in action. The above extract is taken from a book. The book is based on a prediction of a more destructive and uncontrollable weapon than the world has yet seen. So you have to name the author from whose book this extract is taken from. So the weapon is fairly obvious here. So you just have to connect the weapon mentioned in the book with an author. As always, the bold parts will work as hints for you. Five more seconds and we'll move on to the 8th question. Question number 8. So a comic was released in the early 2000s which explored the question: what would have happened if X's rocket landed in Y instead of Z? The whole story of this comic takes place over a period of half a century from 1950s to early 2000s, which is the backdrop of the heightened tension between the nations of Y and Z. So with his superhuman abilities, the character of X expands the ideology and influence of the state of Y to almost every other country of the world, with the exception being Z. The cost of this expansion and progress is paid by degradation of human rights of its citizens. The character of X becomes a big brother-like figure, always listening with his superhuman ears and penetrating walls with his vision, constantly monitoring everything. So you have to identify the character X and the country Y. So for the answer, just type out in the 8th question blank in the G form, just write the answer as X, Y. Also, the timeline mentioned here is very important, like 1950s to 2000s, and the backdrop of heightened tension between the nations Y and Z. So that would lead you to the country Y. Okay, 5 more seconds and we'll move on to the 9th question. Question number 9. So X's mother filed a lawsuit against her son, stating that X slandered her in various podcasts and print interviews and sued for $10 million for the damage to her reputation. The lyrics of song are as follows: 99% of my life I was lied to. I just found out my mom does more dope than I do. I told her I'd grow up to be famous, dash, make a record about doing drugs and name it after her. So you have to identify X, whose mother filed a lawsuit against him. So this is a fairly straightforward question. So we'll move on to the next question quickly. So 5 more seconds and then we'll move on to the 10th question. Question number 10. So this film was banned in X. So X is a country. So this film was banned in X because it somewhat marked the 100th anniversary of the birth of their founder. The government of X found the movie extremely offensive and somewhat of a slander to their precious year. Several people were hence arrested for watching or even on possession of pirated copies of the film. The government said it was the year that the country achieved its long-cherished dream of becoming a rising superpower in the world. In this light, the nation would not tolerate anything, let alone a movie that seeks to depict that special year in negative light. So you don't have to name the country X where the movie was banned. You just have to name the movie which was banned. So name of the movie for the answer for question number 10. Moving on to the next question in 5 seconds. Question number 11. So in the early 2000s, during a presentation to the UN Council on the invasion of Iraq, a reproduction of the painting X hanging in the UN building was covered with a cloth. So the painting X is the magnum opus of one of the most influential artists of the 20th century. It was painted after bombing of a civilian town resulted in deaths of hundreds of innocent civilians. Since then, the painting has become a stark reminder of the human cost of war with its lack of color, jagged and cramped artistic style. So which painting am I talking about? So the style of painting, which is lack of color, jagged and cramped, this might lead you to the artist of this painting, and also the first and second paragraph on the subject matter of the painting or the background of the painting might lead you to the actual name of the painting. So remember that the bold parts serve as hints. Five more seconds and we'll move on to the 12th question. Question number 12. So there is this sculpture which was made by an Italian artist after a major event that happened in 1987. Since then, the sculpture has become a prominent icon for the place where it is kept, as well as a cultural icon appearing most notably in a Nicolas Cage movie where the sculpture comes to life. The sculpture is described as a display of aggression and energy and unpredictability, with its head lowered and body facing to a side ready to dart. While the sculpture became a global icon, the sculptor still continued to work alone outside of the formal art market. His major work in a long time came in 2018 and was sold for $400,000. So identify this the sculpture X, which is the most famous creation. So the main hints would be the sculpture is famous for the place where it is kept, and also it is described as a display of aggression, energy and unpredictability. Five more seconds, then we'll move on to the next question. Question number 13. So, X, a person, starred in 1956 film. Also featured in the movie was an experiment from Levi's, black denim. Originally named Levi's X Jeans, they were aimed at the young youth market. Originally, X disliked jeans, but this moment in cinema holds huge significance in fashion and culture. Firstly, for the birth of black jeans, which would become a style icon on its own. And secondly, Levi's association with X made a significant contribution to the jeans becoming a must-have item for the youth of 1950s, helping Levi's to compete against Lee, who had the endorsement of James Dean, who wore Lee's 101s in Rebel Without a Cause. So we have to name the person X who starred in the 1956 film and was also part of the experiment from Levi's. Also, X is a significant cultural, American cultural icon. Moving on to the next question in 5 seconds. Question number 14. So, according to the author, the title of his book is based on an incident that happened in 1971. So, when the author was in his youth, he was traveling around Europe with a copy of a guidebook detailing all the ways to survive on the road. The opening page of the book that he was carrying read, "Dash is a game of chance. We expect things to run on time, but it is seldom the case. Just because the nth car doesn't stop doesn't mean the n plus 1th car will stop, but you'll get to your destination eventually." So the dash in these lines is a verb which describes the process which is described in these lines. Also, the dash is also the part of the title of the book which the author wrote. So with a copy of this travel guide in his hands, he was lying down drunk on the grass, looking up at the stars, when the idea to write a book came to his mind. So you have to identify which book did the author eventually write. So remember that the dash in these quoted lines is also part of the title of the book which the author came up with. So think of a verb which relates to traveling around in cars. So the line, just because the nth car doesn't stop doesn't mean the n plus oneth car will stop. So connect that to a verb and that might lead you to the answer. Also, looking up at the stars is also a major hint in this question. Okay, so moving on to the next question in 5 seconds. Question number 15. So that's how the story goes, if you believe the anonymous author who heard it from a guy who heard it from his uncle Frank, who was inspired to search for the skull after a member of parliament promised 300 guineas to anyone who could find it. Even archaeologists are pretty much convinced that the skull is not in the grave, as at some point in history someone took it. The mystery of the skull still prevails. So in this excerpt, whose grave are we talking about? Moving on to the next question in 5 seconds. Okay, so question number 16 to 20 are all star marked questions, as you can see on the top left, and each of these questions carry 2 marks and all have 2 points which are marked as 16A, 16B, 17A, 17B, and so on. So we have to write the indicated answer which is mentioned in the G form. So question 16. One might be quick to assume that they are being led to battle, but no, this painting depicts a dynamic scene with bodies littered on the floor and faint smoke in the air. A flag-bearing person leading an energetic and roaring group of people, which is a scene of hard-earned victory. At the time of this painting, the painters usually followed the guidelines set by the School of Fine Arts, but the artist of our painting went out of his way to add striking colors to his painting. A popular album from the 2000s also referenced this painting on their cover art. One of the songs in this album talks about a king who has been disposed of his position. Also, the song has notable Christian and historical references. So you have to identify the painting which is described in the first paragraph and the name of the album which is described in the second paragraph. So remember to write the answer of like the name of the painting in the answer box mentioned as 16A and the name of the album in 16B. As always, the bold parts serve as hints. So think of a painting with a flag-bearing person leading an energetic and roaring group of people. And also to a 2000s album, in which one of the most popular songs from that album talks about a king who has been disposed of his position. And also the song has notable Christian and historical references. Okay, 5 more seconds, then we'll move on to the next question. Question number 17. So X was known for his penchant to transcend genres ranging from rock and pop to opera and disco. And he had the utmost respect for Y, who was at the height of his own reign with his 1982 album, which arguably is still the best-selling album worldwide. It all started when X became pals with Y in the early 80s, with both stars being at the top of their game. They decided to double up and work together on a number of duets. However, the project hit a roadblock when Y insisted on bringing his pet llama to the recording studio, which didn't bode well with X. A conversation X had with his manager goes as follows. I'm recording with a llama. Y is bringing his pet llama into the studio every day, and I'm really not used to recording with a llama. And I've had enough and I want to get out. Identify X and Y, and remember to answer X as 17A and Y as 17B. So X is a star who has vocals ranging from rock and pop to opera and disco. Okay, moving on to the next question in 5 seconds. Question number 18. So in 2014, Pharrell's song Happy was nominated for an Academy Award for the best song for the movie Despicable Me 2, but it lost to another song. He was asked about the scene right after the ceremony by a magazine. A part of the conversation goes as follows. You were nominated for an Oscar that night, but didn't win. How badly did you want it? Well, trust me, when they read the results, my face was X. But when I thought about it, I decided just to Y. So you have to identify X and Y, the exact same phases. And remember to answer X as 18A and Y as 18B. Five more seconds, then we'll move on to the next question. Question number 19. So initially, X was chosen to direct the movie. He really wanted to work on this, particularly because the protagonist also belonged to Pondicherry. But he ultimately decided not to because the movie had a twist at the end, and X, being already famous for putting twists in the end of his movies, thought that his name on the movie would ruin the experience. Then after X left, two more directors were hired, but they also left eventually. The fourth and final director who successfully directed the movie stated water with its flow and reflection as his main inspiration to create this amazing theatrical 3D experience for the audience. So X has been awarded Padma Shri and also been nominated for two Academy Awards. The movie which is being talked about is based on a novel whose author was hired to teach a course titled Animals in Literature at a university after the critical and financial success of his novel. So X is a director from Pondicherry and he has been awarded Padma Shri and also been nominated for two Academy Awards. So report the answer X as 19A and the movie which he was chosen to direct but he eventually left as 19B. Okay, so 5 more seconds, then we'll move on to the final question of the prelims. Question number 20. So there's a museum in Tokyo which is dedicated to X. So X is a corporation. This museum is designed by the founder of X, who planned the whole structure similar to how he used storyboards in his career. So storyboards are basically panels that you use to plan the whole plot of a story. So So the building itself is part of the whole exhibition, consisting of spiraling staircases on both inside and outside. The museum houses bookstores, cafes, gift shops, and a rooftop garden with a tall robot statue, a playroom for children with a large cat, and a theater. At the entrance of the museum, a large Y welcomes you, as is shown in the image on the right. So you have to identify X and its founder. So report X as 20A and the founder of X as 20B. So this was the last question of the quiz. Now you have 90 seconds to submit the G form. And after submitting the G form, to go to the answer discussion live stream, you can click on the link that is in the description of this YouTube video. Or after you submit the G form, there should be a link on the submission page. So you can click on that and you can access the answer discussion live stream. So remember that as the timer goes out, the G form would be closed and you would be no longer, we would no longer be accepting any responses. So you have about 54 seconds remaining to submit the G form. If you have submitted the G form, you should be able to see a link which will lead you to the answer discussion live stream. Or else you can check out the video description. Last 10 seconds remaining. So if you have not submitted the G form, please do it now. Well, now the G form is closed and thank you for participating. I hope to see you all in the finals.